Hello everyone, I am Hannah, an English teacher at Virtually Fluent, and today we are going to focus on the most important British brands and their correct pronunciation. So the first brand is Burberry. And this is a luxury fashion brand from London. They are quite famous for their tartan pattern on their accessories and their clothing. So this is Burberry. The next company is a massive pharmaceuticals company, quite a famous brand. And they make medications and vaccines, most notably the first vaccine for malaria. This is pronounced GlaxoSmithKline. GlaxoSmithKline. Some people often use the acronym GSK instead. Number three is in the automotive sector, and this is a luxury car company. They actually merged with another British company in 2013 with Land Rover. This is Jaguar. Now that J sound is really harsh in English. Jaguar, Jaguar. This next brand is a high street clothing store, and this also has that same J sound in the name. Jack Wills, Jack Wills, Jack Wills. Next is another luxury fashion brand, very famous for their leather bags. They have gorgeous leather bags. And this is Mulberry. Oh, Mulberry. It's a very boring sound in English. Mulberry, Mulberry, Mulberry. The next brand is also a luxury fashion retailer. They started out with just men's clothes, but now they've expanded into women's clothes too. And this is Paul Smith. Not Paul, Paul. It's a long or sound. Paul Smith, Paul Smith. Next, we're moving on to a publishing house, quite an old company from 1935. And this company publishes all types of books. Penguin Books. Penguin, quite a difficult word to say because we have that sound in the middle. Penguin, not penguin. Penguin, penguin, penguin books, penguin books. Now we're moving over to the hotel sector, and the Premier Inn is a very big hotel chain in the UK. So if you're looking to stay in the UK, you might see this as an option. They used to have their hotels only in the suburbs and the outskirts of cities, and of course near airports too, but they have quite a lot of city centre hotels now as well. And this is Premier Inn, Premier Inn, Premier Inn. Number nine is Rimmel. And they started out as a perfume company, but now they also offer makeup and cosmetics. They have such a great brand name because this word Rimmel is traditionally a Mediterranean word. And if you translate this Mediterranean word into English, it means mascara, which is the liquid that we use on our eyelashes. However, even though this is a Mediterranean word, we pronounce it with an English pronunciation. This would be Rimmel, Rimmel, with the stress on the first syllable, Rimmel. And the last company is a multi-billion pound telecommunications company headquartered in London. This is pronounced Vodafone. All the vowels are very long, not Vodafone, it's Vodafone, Vodafone, Vodafone. Now, this video is all about British brands, but I'm going to throw in one extra brand for you, an Irish brand, because I've heard it mispronounced so many times. This is Primark, not Primark. Primark. So this company is a high street fashion retailer, and the original name in Ireland was Pennies, But when they wanted to expand outside Ireland into Europe and North America, this trade name was already taken by somebody else. So they had to change the name and they chose Primark. So please, this is I, Primark, Primark. So those are the most important British brands with more difficult pronunciation. There is something else I want to point out, and this is using acronyms. I'm sure many of you already know the English alphabet. However, when people start to say acronyms for brand names, for some reason, the English alphabet appears to change pronunciation. Every letter in an acronym is pronounced the way that it should be in the English alphabet. Let's take a look at a few examples. The first one is BBC, not BBC, it's BBC, same as the English alphabet. It's one of the biggest companies in the UK, the media companies, they have the radio, TV, news channels, BBC. The next one is BP, British Petroleum, BP, BP. Next we have HSBC, a massive financial company. Next we have BAE Systems, BAE, British Aerospace Systems. This is a massive defense, security and aerospace company, BAE Systems. So there we have it, the correct British English pronunciation for some British brands.